AdamandJP.com.
Right now.
Exploring the multiverse of pop culture.
This is Pod Casserole.
An Adam and JP show.
Hey, why are you listening to this when you should be listening to Childish Gambino, This Is America?
Hopefully you've heard it and seen it many times.
Go watch the video.
Yeah.
Why are you wasting your time here?
I've watched that at least 15 times so far.
I sat and watched it three times the other night.
Mm-hmm. You have to at least two or three, at least.
Chilling.
Yeah.
This isn't, and I know this seems bandwagon-y and this seems however you want to label it, because we like to label things, which is kind of plays into that that video.
Right, yeah.
Most important music video of the last 20 years?
Yeah, I'd say so. I think of one more important than that.
Just the little details in that, when he shoots the first, I guess if you haven't seen This Is America, you don't know what we're talking about. When he fires
video
the first
spoiler?
Gun. Yeah. And look at the care he handles the gun afterwards.
And the dead body's just drugged to the floor like it's nothing, like it's trash.
Uh-huh.
But the gun's taken away in like this nice velvety red rag.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then when he pops in the room with the choir.
Oh, man.
And it's all, and that's how we are.
Yeah.
It's tragic.
And it's like, oh, wow, he's dancing again. Let's forget about that.
Yeah, let's forget about it. Move on.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
When I was watching Community, you remember when I used to tell you, man, Community's really good. Mm-hmm. You should watch Community.
Yeah.
Back when it was actually, on NBC. I never thought Donald Glover would become that well-rounded and powerful of a performer.
Weird, huh? Yeah.
He was really good on the show.
Yeah. That's what I saw.
And Danny Putty.
Yeah.
Because they had them grouped together a lot. But
I already tweeted this week that he is the kind of genius that Kanye West wants to be, and it makes sense.
It's true.
Yeah.
It's true. So do you think Kanye, and we've had this discussion more than once on this show, is he just trolling us? He is, isn't he?
What's the point? I guess at that point you have so much money and fame, why not?
Yeah, I guess.
I mean,
maybe?
Yeah.
I don't know. Mm. But I do think he's trolling us.
You think so?
He's not.
Because, I used to like him a lot.
Uh-huh.
I did. And I stand by it. His old stuff is fantastic and brilliant, but somewhere like 10-ish years ago, something happened.
Maybe he's just a gold digger.
Maybe.
Way over town. The dig's on me.
It's possible.
On a lighter note, welcome to Pod Casserole.
Hey there.
And I have the Friday song queued up and ready.
Ooh.
A little more current than we did last week.
Yeah, a little bit.
Portugal the Man from the album Woodstock.
I always love an artist with a comma in their name. It's fancy.
Is it a comma or a period?
Oh, it's a comma, right? Portugal the Man, right? Is it? I'm pretty sure.
I thought it was a period.
It is a period. You're right. I could have sworn I've always seen a comma.
This is a great song.
That makes zero sense.
Portugal, the Man.
The comma made sense.
Like, please welcome
Tyler, the creator. It makes a comma makes sense, but this doesn't make sense.
Please welcome Portugal, the Man.
That's a different. You have to say it like a different sentence. Please welcome Portugal, the Man.
The Man.
Yeah.
Oh wait, it's not. It's not a question mark.
But it's. it's weird. I can't think. I don't know.
This is good. But I think it needs a little extra something. It just...
Like what?
I don't know. There's something missing in this song. Maybe an accordion? Possibly.
You think so?
It's just a thought. I keep my hands on myself. Take out those two more, put them back up on the shelf. Kiss my little baby girl as a knee. Am I coming out of left field? Ooh, I'm a rebel just for kicks. Hey. I've been feeling it since 1966. Hey.
So at that point, why name your album Woodstock? Tell me that.
Why is the cover a burning car?
So many questions. The best friend of Snoopy, the bird Woodstock, was that before or after 1969's music festival? Which one came first?
I thought Woodstock came like the bird.
You would think so, right?
Yeah.
Well, so what was that? Like, what does that mean? Woodstock, the festival itself was around that location in New York.
Woodstock, New York, yeah. Right.
But what if the Woodstock bird? What's his motive?
Well, I guess he was named probably after the festival.
But you said it was before.
Well, I'm just guessing. I don't know.
Let's check out. But why would you name your album? That's just weird to me. You can't, like, I mean, today's the age of Google. Think about your Googling yourself.
What if it was Woodstock, period? The city?
It's like, it's like you're naming a podcast a show. Think about it.
So, Portugal, the man, actually requested Weird Al remix two of their songs.
Yeah. That's pretty awesome.
So this is an official release. And it kind of sets the tone. What? What'd you just find out?
The history of Woodstock. The character Woodstock first appeared April 4th, 1967. That's 2 years before 69's Woodstock. The character remained unnamed until June 1970.
Interesting. So that kind of sets the tone for today's show.
Yeah.
Now, look, I know what you're thinking. How much could you really talk about Weird Al? Well, here's a news flash.
Well, you see.
Settle in. We're going to play. This is the complete works of Weird Al Yankovic. We're going to play every song by Weird Al.
This may turn more people away than a wrestling show. We'll see. Yeah,
well, it's going to be fun. We're going to go through, just play some of our favorites,
yeah,
talk about, you know, what Weird Al means to us. Because honestly, how many artists have had a 40-plus year career and clearly is staying relevant?
I think it's because the
evidence of that remix.
Yeah, yeah. When did that? That's pretty recent. I mean, it's the song's a year old.
March.
Yeah.
Wow. Came out in March. The remix.
Huh.
Yeah.
I never heard that until now.
Uh huh.
I think it's.
Would you like to hear it again?
No, it's all right. I think I'm all right. But it's a Weird Al in general. Before people love or hate this episode, it's a very love or hate relationship people have with him.
It really is. But I don't know many people who don't at least like something Weird Al has done. Maybe they're not a huge fan like I am.
Yeah.
But they liked White and Nerdy. You know? They thought Tacky was funny. They liked White and Nerdy.
Yeah.
You know, maybe they don't go all the way to Mabalona. That's okay.
No deep cuts?
No, Dare to Be Stupid.
No Another One Rides the Bus? No deep cuts?
No. But usually somebody likes something Weird Al has done. Maybe it's The Saga Begins.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Perhaps it's foil.
Yeah.
With the aluminum foil. That's coming up.
Right.
Before we get into the Weird Al goodness, you and I just spent about an hour doing an unaired podcast.
We did, yeah.
About Avengers Infinity War.
Yeah, and the MCU in general. It's
Yeah. You're like going through.
Yeah, so I saw Infinity War again. Saw it twice.
Uh-huh.
And before my second viewing this past week or two, I've kind of went through, once again, almost every MCU movie.
Yeah.
I would say I've rewatched them all except for Age of Ultron. I can't find Age of Ultron to stream anywhere.
Yeah.
But most of those...
I think I have that one. I can always borrow that one.
All the Iron Man movies, Thor except for that, or Thor, even Dark World, saw that. Captain America's, all those.
New appreciation for the first Avenger?
Yeah, I like the first Avenger now. Yeah.
You liked Iron Man 3 when we reviewed it.
Right, yeah.
Recently.
And I still stand strong with
it. Yeah.
I think we should do it soon. I know we're trying to slowly do that with our MCU recollection days, but that will be years from now to finish that. Have our final countdown. We should do an actual 1 through 19 countdown.
Just
our
do
favorite,
it.
Our favorite to least favorite soon.
Yeah. Okay. You've got yours,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I do.
I think I know what number one is.
For you?
For you.
Oh,
I don't know that it's number one for me.
Yeah. You don't mean...
And I don't want to know. Don't tell me.
Yeah. Do you know what your number one is, though, is my question.
I think I do know what my number one
really?
Is.
Really?
Yeah.
I think I know what it is, too, for you.
What do you think it is?
You love Iron Man. You love it.
I mean, I do have a soft spot for the original Iron Man.
I know you do.
And Iron Man 3 has really gone up in my book over the last few years.
Should we do it next week or do you wait 2 weeks?
Well, we'd have to wait 2 weeks because I got to give it some thought.
Yeah, okay.
Well, maybe in between shows.
That's what I thought.
Because I kind of have it in my mind it would be.
It's not as tough as you think. You just have to have them all written down and kind of fill the blank.
I think I could do that.
Okay, yeah.
And you have yours.
It's ready to go.
All right, well. Yeah. Breaking news. coming up next week, we're going to do it.
Yeah.
Our official ranking of the MCU movies.
Good, you know, 2 or 3 weeks removed from Infinity
but
War.
But I haven't seen Black Panther yet.
Oh, you haven't. Can't do it then.
Yeah.
You won't see it in the next 2 weeks, will you?
No.
Well
maybe. Wow. It's out on Blu-ray now.
That's true.
How
did you miss that in theater?
It's a crazy time. It's a crazy, crazy time. I'm honestly amazed I made it to see Infinity
really?
War.
Really? Yeah.
But well, we could do that. I could probably have like an asterisk for Black Panther.
Yeah.
I could lean on you
18, yeah.
to kind of place it.
Did I tell you how much we spent at the theater second time around?
Mm-mm.
Man. So it was
Oh, you went to IMAX, right?
Well, we went to the dining theater.
Oh.
We did 3D there. So first off, the tickets were 23 apiece.
The theater with MacGuffins? I love that name.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
So it was 46 for tickets. We wound up spending well over triple digits in all just two of us.
Over $100?
Yeah.
What did you have to drink?
It's called the Mad Titan. I had to have it. It's true.
If you're watching Infinity War.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I guess you should.
Have you been to the diner? Oh, man, the kickback recliners, and you just hit a button, and someone comes up and brings you everything.
Is it worth $100?
No regrets.
I think it's I can
destiny.
Do it.
Run from it.
I think I can lean on you to advise me on Black Panther,
yeah.
and we can do a list.
Let's do it. Okay.
With the caveat, Black Panther could go up or down
right.
on my list. But yeah. I think, just from what I've heard, it should probably be in my top five.
Yeah. Maybe so. It depends what you're feeling. It's not for me.
Yeah.
I loved it, but top five's tough in the MCU.
That's true.
I mean, you have to... Yeah, it's a lot. It's tough.
When we're making the list, I'd be like, is it better than... is it better than Dark World?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's probably my least favorite.
That's my number 19. Just a little teaser there.
Yeah.
Dark World's number 19.
Mm-hmm. Guardians is pretty low on my list, too.
Yeah?
I'm joking.
I saw a guy's list recently that legitimately his number 19 was Thor Ragnarok. Interesting, huh?
Really?
Yeah.
Though you weren't a huge fan either, I think you and I would disagree on Thor Ragnarok.
I don't think we spoke. So I saw it twice in theaters.
Uh-huh.
Second time, I liked it much more.
Yeah.
I don't know if I told you that. First time was a little too comedic. Second time was still too comedic for me, but it was better than what I mean, it's I think, you know, three quarters of the way down,
uh-huh.
I believe.
Before we took the sabbatical,
yeah.
it was the last thing, one of the last things we talked
that
about.
That makes sense, because I saw it between the, yep.
But you hadn't seen Justice League then.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Once you see that, every other movie looks much better. It brings it up a notch.
It's pretty funny.
I mean, Nutty Professor 2 was so good.
Nut Job 2.
I can
Nutty by Nature.
This is not me fanboying, but I think Justice League is terrible.
Oh, it's not good.
I mean, really.
But it's like I said when we talked about it last year.
Yeah.
There's some good moments in Justice League, but they're overshadowed by the mess that movie was.
I will never, ever, ever watch it again. Ever.
It was...
Ever.
However, you know, that movie gets a lot of beef for having two directors and directors being changed out and this and that.
But it wouldn't have, I mean, we saw Batman v Superman. It wouldn't have fixed that.
That's true.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, there were problems with Back to the Future.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Like they shot a quarter of the movie and then did reshoots with a totally different actor.
I've seen that in the behind the scenes, like the Eric Stoltz footage.
Eric Stoltz was in it.
Yeah.
And that's so funny to think now that when you hear, oh, they're doing reshoots, there's reshoots, there's problems.
Yeah.
What if you heard that about Back to the Future?
But now, what is Superman's actual name? Henry
Kal-El?
Cavill? Henry Cavill. I saw an article yesterday. He's kind of almost bashing Warner Brothers, saying the way they handled the, first off, the mustache thing was stupid.
Yeah. That's not his fault.
Right.
That's
not on him. He was saying that was poorly executed, and even more so was the advertisements for Justice League having zero mention of Superman when everyone knew he was in there.
Yeah.
Like the commercials, trailers had nothing, posters had nothing, but everyone knew he was there.
Because they're trying to keep it a secret?
Yeah.
We know it's called Justice League.
Right.
Superman's kind of an important part of that.
Yeah.
Plus, you knew at the end of Batman v Superman he was coming back.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone knew.
Yeah, you have a teaser of his, his coffin shaking?
Yeah.
The dirt on there?
Oh, yeah. I'm a huge Superman fan.
Wait. Now that I think about it, why was that happening? Weird.
At the end of Batman
v Superman? Yeah, because he was dead.
Well,
until they brought him back with a Lazarus.
Well, I think in the storyline.
Weird. Well, I actually not thought about that.
In the storyline they were going to do.
Yeah.
He would have, you know, he would have brought himself
classic
back.
Jesus 3 days resurrection.
Basically.
With a mullet.
Right. You're not wrong.
Yeah, yeah.
But I think they went with a different
resurrection
of Superman.
And it was weeks, months, who knows how long passed. And they had to use that Lazarus thing in the actual ship to bring him back to life.
Uh-huh.
He was evil for a few minutes until he saw his woman.
Right.
And then, wow, the end of Batman v Superman, it was almost like immediate comeback, that shaking of the coffin.
I think what I try to hold on to with those DC movies it is not the actor's fault. Most of the time, most of the actors they have cast in those roles are amazing in those roles.
And they think Henry they're going to be the next big movie. It's sad, you know?
But Henry Cavill is a good Superman.
Yeah.
I don't have any problem with the way he portrays Superman. I have a problem with the way it's written. I have a problem with the way it's directed. And stuff like that whole mustache thing, which was, he had nothing. There was literally nothing he could do about that.
Forgot that even happened.
Yeah.
I put it in the Blu-ray player. I'm like, oh.
Yeah.
I forgot. I wasn't looking for it. That's how bad it was. That noticeable.
I think Gal Gadot is good as Wonder Woman.
I can't do that.
You don't like her as Wonder Woman?
And that boy, that accent kills me.
I don't mind the accent.
Kal-El. What are you doing? Like, I know she's from wherever, but she's...
Israel. She's,
yeah.
Israeli.
You've seen...
She was in the Israeli army.
You've seen Hugh Jackman as Wolverine, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Hey.
He says bub, not mate.
Deadpool comes out this weekend.
It does, yeah.
Apparently, there's a big cameo in Deadpool.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what it is?
Yeah, I just read it. I'm not going to say it, though.
Is it huge?
Maybe.
Is it Hugh Jackman?
Maybe. I don't know. Well, I just read the... Because it'll be a few weeks... before I can see it.
Yeah.
And I love, love, love.
Well, that. You spent so much money.
I know. We're in a drought now for a bit. That was crazy, yeah.
I'm going to save up my movie
money.
It was
like $140, man.
That's ridiculous. What did you have to eat?
So this is back when we're eating badly still. So it was, I had, what was it called? It was some kind of meat over macaroni and cheese.
Uh-huh.
It was a brisket. Brisket, macaroni, and cheese.
That sounds delicious.
It was delicious.
And expensive.
She had like a flatbread
pizza.
Yeah, pizza thing.
Yeah.
And then she had a an ice cream sundae, and I had my Mad Titan.
Titans.
They had the red, white, and blue Captain America, but I was purple all day.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
With the old Infinity Gauntlet.
Yeah. It was good,
which you didn't realize was broken.
I didn't,
until
yeah.
the second time.
Yeah. I mean, one more semi-spoiler of Infinity War. We'll have 2 minutes of a talk here. So.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Forget.
Not everyone's seen it. Fast forward 2 minutes here if you haven't seen it yet. Just give me 2 minutes.
How I'm still avoiding Black Panther podcast.
Give me two.
I don't want to know.
It's so funny. You ask me questions in Infinity War about certain things, and I can't say anything because you haven't seen it. You may not have even known that it was treacherous territory to talk about it, but I'm just like, Yeah.
Oh, when I said, is that Killmonger?
I can't.
And you're like, meh.
I'm I can't say things.
Well, I assumed... Oh, we're in spoiler, right?
We're still in the two-minute spoiler.
Okay.
Yeah, this is Black Panther and Infinity War spoilers.
So I assumed, having not seen Black Panther, mm-hmm. that when you see Winter Soldier, you know, working on the farm down in Wakanda, chopping wood, that he's in Black Panther. But apparently he's not.
Hmm.
And see, I've been told he's not.
Post-credit scene.
Oh, okay.
That's what he is there. Yeah.
Is he working on the farm?
Yeah.
Chopping wood?
Yeah.
With one arm?
White Wolf, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's him.
Yeah. Because, you know, last time I saw him, he was frozen.
Right.
And now he's not.
Yeah.
So I assumed he got thawed out in Black Panther.
Yeah. Well, he was frozen in Wakanda, though, right? That's where they took him?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Is that with the spoilers?
No. Wait, is that all of it? Yeah. Give me 30 more seconds of spoilers.
Okay, go ahead.
We talked about the Infinity Gauntlet. I didn't see until the second viewing. I had no idea that Thanos' actual gauntlet was toast.
Yeah.
I believe the stones were as well, so we'll see what happens.
Yeah. I don't know how they... And like I told you, I think that was done to eliminate the possibility that the gauntlet factors in to reversing everything that happened.
I really believe, like I told you off mic, the people that disintegrated into nothingness, that died, quote-unquote, are the ones that actually lived, the ones that stayed behind or stuck in the reality stone, and they're the dead ones.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I think.
Yeah. I think you're right. I'm with that.
I mean,
the theory you told me is interesting.
Which one?
That it's the reverse.
Right, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I think.
You think it's the reverse?
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Like,
you think the ones that disappeared went back to the reality?
Yeah. And I think whenever he snapped his fingers, pretty much the whole universe went to the reality stone. The ones that disintegrated go back to reality. The ones that did not stay in the stone.
They're the ones that have to fight out of the stone.
Yeah. That's what I would think.
Interesting.
I don't think so.
And I also think, having thought about it, I haven't seen it a second time, but the young Gamora that he speaks to, since mm-hmm. he's actually speaking about current events, that is an indication that Gamora still exists somewhere.
You think so, huh?
Inside the stone. And I thought that was inside the stone. That was my take.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I thought. They were actually in the soul gem, the soul stone.
Yeah.
Cold stone. My favorite ice cream shop.
We'll see, huh?
I don't know.
Yeah. I don't know.
Is that spoiler? Is that anything else?
Was there one more? I guess that's it.
So you know who the big cameo is in Deadpool.
Yeah.
Is it a known actor from another comic series?
You're
going to
ask me questions until I spoil it. Now, you don't want that. Just wait and see it.
Okay.
See that over Solo.
I hear Domino's great in it.
Yeah.
That's what I've heard.
See it over Solo. See it three times. See Solo none. Nunts.
73% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Which one?
Solo.
I think I may not even watch that ever.
I don't know why you're so down on Solo.
A Star Wars release used to be a special moment.
Yeah.
Now it's just like every year, man.
Well.
I'll take the numbered installments, but those in between.
We said we wanted this.
They can suck it.
We said we wanted this. Imagine if we got a Star Wars movie every year. That would be awesome. Well, here we are. This is what that reality looks like.
Yeah.
Do you want to use the stone and go back?
Yeah.
You want to wipe this reality away?
10 more seconds of spoiler for Infinity War. I think it has to be that way because right now, not only are the stones gone, but most of people's powers are gone. I mean, Tony Stark is stuck on Titan, stranded with no way to get back at all whatsoever.
With Nebula.
Yeah. They're stranded. There's no way for them to get back logically. So what's going to happen? I mean, what could happen? They're stranded.
How could they get part of the Nova Corps show up on Titan?
I guess. I always wonder. They never ever speak of. I mean, it took me 10 hours to fly from here to Hawaii.
Yeah.
Can't imagine going from Earth to outside of our galaxy to Titan. And they act like
they did make that trip pretty fast.
Yeah. Wherever Thor was, I forget the name of the planet, to make his a new weapon. Seems like, right down the street from Titan.
Uh-huh.
And he shows up. I really wonder if they could.
Well, when you have.
Give me a quick time lapse. 12 hours later. Something like that.
Tony Stark drove from Chattanooga to Miami in Iron Man 3. Pretty quickly.
Yeah.
It was dark. Like, it's kind of, ambiguous.
Yeah.
Like, it's dark, so it could be, 7 o'clock dark or 11 p.m. dark or 1 o'clock in the morning dark, and then he shows up in Miami, at the crack of dawn.
Yeah.
I don't think you can make that drive from Chattanooga to Miami.
Maybe he had
fast.
Some stops at a few Denny's, and it was, the day after.
That's what I want to see.
Yeah.
I want to see Tony Stark at Denny's a Stuckey's.
At a pilot getting an icy.
Trying to figure out what he wants. Guessing up on the way. Checking his messages.
Stuckies, that's funny.
Yeah. All right.
Spoilers are done.
Do you want to do NWO or SOB?
NWO first. Let's do it.
All right, here we go. This week in NWO news, by request, something that we were actually asked to investigate.
That is true.
And that is the, what?
Konami, are they being run by the Yakuza?
Yeah, the Japanese mob.
Yeah, is that happening?
Is that happening?
Is that a thing? Some would say so, and this is all speculation, as most things in the NWO news is. Let's go down that road, shall we?
We sent our own Adam Hewitt to investigate.
It's true. I'm
now with the report for NWO News.
I came back in from Tokyo last night. I drove. It only took about 3 hours.
You drove. Uh-huh. Nice. That's weird.
So some people say Konami is a front for the Yakuza, which is the Japanese mob, like we said. Quick history of Konami. They've had great games. The Metal Gear Solid franchise, Silent Hill, Contra. They're known for the Konami code. Great games since the late 70s, possibly early 80s. But now they're kind of almost, some would say, liquidating their assets, putting out releases that are almost guaranteed to make no money, firing great creators like Hideo Kojima, which is behind the Metal Gear Solid franchise, and just every big game, every big thing they put out now is kind of guaranteed to not make money, but they have their money elsewhere in these pachinko machines in Japan. Pachinko is kind of a Japanese version of a slot machine, so gambling is illegal in Japan. But pachinko is very good because with this, you can put money in there and win physical prizes, but they have redemption centers later. Later on, you can return those prizes for money. So it's gambling with multiple steps involved, if that makes sense.
Right.
So these pachinko machines are around the country, have Konami stamped on them, and most people know these pachinko machines, this underground gambling scene, is pretty much ran by the Yakuza.
Yeah.
And it's kind of weird that Konami has their name on that. Here in the States and across the world, everything they're known for almost purposefully is being just crushed to nothing, but all their money instead is being sent over to Japan in these pachinko machines. Which I also see, I went to Tunica a few months ago and I saw Konami on American slot machines as well. So it's not just in Japan, even though they think it's kind of a Japanese mob underground belly to it, but it's here in America too.
So the biggest development in this downfall of a gaming company story goes back to the early days that we were doing this, the Silent Hill, They even went so far as to film a trailer for the Silent Hill game.
Yeah.
A playable demo was released.
Yeah.
Norman Reedus was part of this, right?
This is the Kojima. It was Kojima and Guillermo del Toro together doing
this. Yeah.
And yeah, it was called going to be called Silent Hills, but they created a whole playable teaser called PT, stood for that, and it was released to the public. People loved it, and it was great, fantastic, had a release date, but out of nowhere, the project was axed, and Del Toro and Kojima were both fired and gone. Now Kojima's off doing his own thing with Norman Reedus still on a game called Death Stranded with a who-knows-when release date.
Mm-hmm.
That's what's happening. But Konami cut all ties with these major... I mean, Kojima's been around since Metal Gear Solid 1.
Yeah.
That's a long time.
Interesting.
Yeah.
So do you believe that they are run by the mob?
No.
You don't think so?
I'm going to say no. If I said yes, they'd come find me, wouldn't they?
Well, no, it's the Japanese mob. But here's the thing.
Yeah.
And here's, I mean, because it sounds, you know, when you say the mob.
Yeah.
I get the impression, now, by all means, of course, let's be realistic, the mob is dangerous. They probably kill people.
Mm-hmm.
But I think, and I really have no research to back this up, other than anecdotes that I've read and heard, that the mob in Japan in 2018 is much like the mob in the U.S. back before Prohibition.
Mm.
And that is, yes, they're there. Yes, they can be rough when they have to be. But by and large, unless you're involved with the mob, they leave you alone.
Yeah.
And they don't. And in Japan, I've heard that, especially when the tsunami hit,
mm-hmm.
that they were very involved in helping people.
Really?
And by no way, and I'm not trying to defend the mob in Japan, but I'm trying to put it into context,
yeah.
that because that's much how the mob used to be in the U.S.
Mm-hmm.
before, you know, back when it was booze and not drugs. And if you've ever seen, a Goodfellas. I think that's a pretty accurate depiction of the evolution of the mob, where it went from this basically, you know, life or death business around illegal gambling and, you know, horse racing and, you know, booze, you know, cigarettes from Canada, mm-hmm. all that stuff that the mob did back then. And then once the drugs got involved, then that just kind of lowered the quality of the business they yeah. kept. And I think the Japanese mob is much like that today.
Let me ask
from
yourself,
what I've read.
It makes sense. It does. You may ask why pachinko machines over anything else in Japan. But the statistics say that pachinko, because of its, you know, the forbidden fruit is the sweetest, they say. So this idea that gambling is illegal in Japan, people love pachinko. It
yeah.
made more money last year than illegal drugs, all of them combined.
Yeah.
That's how much money pachinko's bringing in. Almost, it's legal, but not legal.
Yeah.
Like I said, you're putting money and you receive a prize that you can take to a redemption center and trade in for money. Like I said, the cycle just recycles itself.
Lots of blind eyes are being turned.
Yeah. Yeah.
Basically.
Pretty much. Mm-hmm. So if there's a way to take the money from Konami, and I don't know. It's just kind of a question of who owns it and where it goes. And it's just odd that a lot of their big players and big games are canceled and they're released. They're terrible now. I think it's a way for people to kind of rectify the situation. Like, we used to love Konami and they used to be so good. Now it's here.
My question that I would want to ask is, when business started to drop for Konami, did they ever go to the Japanese mob for an influx of cash?
Hmm.
And is that where the turning point happened?
Yeah.
That they, if they do have an influence or if they even own Konami, you know, they're probably not on the books they own Konami, but they own Konami.
Yeah.
So I don't know. It's interesting.
Weird, huh?
The second part of this week in NWO news is an update. Do you remember, we've played this clip several times on the show. I'm not even going to play the whole thing here, but it's from Art Bell, the Coast to Coast, the creepy audio clip of the caller.
Art.
Okay, what we're thinking of as aliens, Art, they're extra-dimensional beings that an earlier precursor of the, space program made contact with. They are not what they claim to be. They have infiltrated a lot of aspects of the military establishment, particularly.
That was in 1998. Caller claiming, and I found this out just this week. It was a little more research than I did on this from the Unbelievable podcast. that was actually on the Art Bell special line, the Area 51 line. Mm-hmm. This guy called in, claimed he was a former employee of Area 51. He'd just been let go. And then they were triangulating his location. They could do that. He was scared. He feared for his life. And while he's talking, the show goes off the air. This was, you know, we've played this. We've talked about this a couple of times. So all this time, I thought, wow, that's got to be one of the creepiest calls ever on Coast to Coast. Right now, on the Unbelievable podcast, which is a show we've talked about before on here, they are doing a tribute month to Art Bell.
A month, wow.
Yeah. And each month, they're kind of, it's been great. If you love Coast to Coast, mm-hmm. you should do yourself a favor and go listen to the past two or three episodes of Unbelievable podcast. There's been some great stuff on there. And so this past week, or this week, I guess, they covered this caller and actually put some closure to it that I didn't realize, that 8 months later, the guy called back in again.
Supposedly from the same guy. And he gets nervous, then hangs up. Then, 1 week after that, on April 28th, 1998, this guy calls again.
Anyway, I'm glad you made it back through.
Yeah, you got all my paranoia buttons running. I always get very nervous when I call you. I'm Brian. I hung up on you last week.
Oh, I see.
He reveals that he is the Area 51 caller, and he just says, flat, straight up, that he was just doing a character.
Wow.
Mystery solved.
Wow.
It was a character.
Wow.
All of that was staged.
And Art Bell had no idea.
Art Bell had no idea. Now, go listen to this. This is episode 247 of the Unbelievable podcast. It's Art Bell A Tribute Month, part 4. They go into way more detail about it, play more of the call from 98 when he calls back in. And he says that he had called the show before and done characters before on the show.
Wow.
And the reason why he wanted to reveal himself is because he wanted to let Art know that even though he was doing a character and it was so creepy that the show just went away while he was on the phone, no clue how that happened.
That's what I was going to ask, how that went together.
That wasn't part of it. But what a creepy coincidence that it would happen in the midst of a call like that.
It's almost like that was a character he did out of nowhere, but stuff like that actually happened and people listening were like, nope.
Yep.
It's almost like it's still kind of creepy.
Yeah, well, that's true. I mean, he could be part of the New World Order, the New World Order, the Illuminati, could be, like, you know, giving us false information again. Like, he wasn't really an actor.
Yeah.
Well, he is now.
Now he is, yeah.
Because he's been brainwashed.
Right.
I don't know. But listen to this episode, because it goes further, and Art even asked him to do that voice again, and he just goes right back
into
it and sounds all panicked and everything.
Oh, man.
It's really
that.
Good, yeah.
I'll check it
and
out.
I guess he's also a comic book artist.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Was Art mad whatsoever for him?
No.
Really?
No. I think Art appreciated that sort of stuff, because it's all kind of performance art in the first place.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, we've talked about this before. Does Art really believe all the stuff he talks about? No, I doubt it. But he knows how to keep it going, to keep the entertainment aspect.
Hmm.
So, mystery solved all these years later.
20 years later.
20 years later.
Wow.
And that will do it for this week in NWO News. If you have a request, something you want us to investigate, did I tell you? Do you remember when we did the Kurt McFall episode?
Yeah.
I don't know if you saw this on YouTube. You remember the LARP organization he was with?
Mm-hmm.
Someone from that organization was chatting with us on the YouTube page.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I can't remember if it was he or she, but they were like, yeah, I'm part of that group. I'm part of that society. This and that. They knew Creepy Gabe.
Really?
Yeah.
We should bring them on.
Yeah.
Interesting.
I keep meaning to tell you that I saw it on the YouTube page.
Wow.
Yeah.
Didn't know that at all.
Yeah. So.
Huh. Okay, then.
We may have to revisit that. Yeah. Actually, something else I want to do in NWO News. Yeah. I want to do a full episode special, Unsolved Mysteries, D.B. Cooper. Because they do
Are
so
you
much.
Sure we didn't do it?
We didn't do the Unsolved Mysteries.
We just did D.B. Cooper.
It was me and you doing it. It was terrible. It was like douchebags doing D.B. Cooper. We should leave it to the professionals. And there's new information about D.B. Cooper.
D.B.'s
too.
On D.B. Cooper. We can do that, yeah.
D.B.'s on D.B. Welcome to D.B.'s on D.B. So do we have time? Yeah, we can squeeze in the SOB OTW. Yeah. You know, Adam, it's really easy to be the SOBOTW. You just have to reach out to us.
It's all about interaction, you know. Online. Anywhere at Adam and JP, of course, patreon.com/podcastroll is fun. AJP at Adam and JP. And of course, even, you know, like an iTunes podcast review or Facebook messages, anything.
Yeah, time is winding down.
Sure is.
As we record this, it is May 17th. You have to June 1st to get 55 star reviews on Apple Podcasts.
Pretty much 2 weeks out.
Currently, we're sitting at 36.
Yeah. Basically, a review a day. Can we do it?
Yeah. That's tough.
Just for a Twinkie. Just if for a we green get 50, Twinkie.
Yeah. We're even going to push the Patreon. We'll push the Patreon thing back. The pickles. We'll let them ferment for a little longer.
There's a ring on top now, isn't it?
Hey, there sure is. They're going to sit there a little while. We'll revisit this in the summer.
Ooh.
But since we're close.
God almighty.
Yeah, I know, right?
There's no AC in this garage, right?
No. Well, there is, but it's not very good.
Yeah.
But I think we can make the 50.
You think so?
55 star reviews on Apple Podcast.
Can we make it 55 five star reviews for a pickle eat? Come on.
No, absolutely not. That's going to be 25 $5 patrons on patreon.com.
Yeah.
So we have some reviews. Reviews from podcast.
And this is one of the greatest names we've seen on here.
Oh, it's my favorite.
We have one from the user on iTunes, the podcast app. His name is Pochop Sandwich.
Pochop Sandwich.
Yeah. Title is Doing My Part. He says, literally just found you guys. I've listened to 20 minutes and I'm a fan.
Mm-hmm.
Says Pochop Sandwich on iTunes.
What's the one before Pochop?
Oh, you're right. We read this one between ourselves.
Yeah.
It hasn't been on the air.
It hasn't been on the air. Yeah.
This is from Sammy Knows Best. And his subject title is Twinkies. He says, Twinkies bring us all together. So do Adam, JP, New Science System, and Foxglove Farm.
Foxglove Farm.
Yeah.
It's our new science system.
Yes, it is.
And it's a lot closer than what we were doing. We looked this up. Do you have it on your screen?
I don't, but I can. This is a great way. If you want to have free advertisements for your product on the show, give us a review, name that. Well, it's kind of like a live read right now.
Yeah, just work it into the review somehow.
Yeah.
Put the name of your band, put the name of your aunt, whatever you want us to say on the air, put in the five-star review,
and
we will read it. And probably it'll pique our interest and we'll research it.
And we'll go on and on about it.
Because
I mean, how many times was New Science System said last week?
A lot.
Yeah.
And the week before that.
Right, yeah.
Like, I feel like maybe we own stock in New Science System now. You know, I put all my money in New Science System.
Right. So, yeah, check out facebook.com/foxglovefarm, PHARM, and check out those goodies. Alternative and holistic health service located in Memphis, Tennessee.
But some of my favorites, because of the names of these.
Right.
Not Today, Satan.
Right.
It's a candle. It's a candle called Not Today, Satan.
There's a Goodnight, Cruel World.
It's a sleep aid, right?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Pretty sure.
Yeah.
There's a Bloody Hell Loose Leaf Tea. There's a loose leaf tea to loosen your morals called Livin' Libido Loca. I mean, who doesn't want Foxglove Farm?
Foxglove Farm is fantastic.
Yeah. Check them out now, facebook.com/foxglovefarm or etsy.com/shop/foxglovefarm. Check it out.
Hi, I'm Jay Patrick from Podcasterole. You know, my life was spiraling out of control, lots of sleepless nights, until I found Foxglove Farm. Now, I'm sleeping with the fishes. Like the fishes?
Multiple reviews on Facebook, all 5 stars, by the way.
For
Foxglove Farm.
Yeah,
facebook.com/foxglovefarm. Check it out on Etsy. Check them out. Awesome Living Libido Loca.
Hey, Adam, you look great.
Yeah, I'm on that new Not Today, Satan. Even though it's a candle, I smell it daily.
Where do you find that?
I find it on facebook.com/foxglovefarm.
You look
fantastic. Also on Etsy.
You look foxglove fantastic.
I've been drinking bloody hell all day. I just now found out what bloody hell's for.
Uh-huh.
It's a loose leaf tea to make your period suck less. True story.
Oh, bloody hell. Facebook.com/Foxglove Farm. I love that name.
Yeah.
Foxglove Farm. It's my new favorite. Do you think Foxglove Farm and New Science System?
I think they're one of the same.
You think there's connection?
Yeah, I think so.
It's possible.
Like Konami Yakuza connection, maybe.
Do you think Pochop Sandwich knows that?
It's possible as well. We plug in Pochop Sandwiches next week.
Hey, coming up, the complete works.
Oh, yeah.
Of Weird Al Yankovic.
Let's do it because I'm excited about it.
there's a fair chance you don't like the news, and I get that. I'm Buzz Burbank, and I do a different kind of newscast I think you will like. I tell stories, true stories, because when you view it the right way, there's nothing more amazing than real life. I cover most of the stuff the big media outlets cover, but often with a different approach, richer in detail, and with a perspective that ties it all together so we have some idea of what it all means. I deliver stories that'll make you laugh, make you cry, and make you angry, because that is the nature of life, and because you cannot be a better citizen unless you understand and feel the news. I also don't cover some of the useless stories you'll find elsewhere, and do cover real stories the rest of the media somehow managed to avoid. With my nearly 40 years' experience in broadcast journalism and a love of writing, this is a news program that's custom-made for you. Buzz Burbank News and Comment is now a weekly show, new each Thursday, and available free on iTunes, SoundCloud, and several other platforms, and at buzzburbank.com. In addition to the other shows you enjoy here on the ESO Broadcast Network, thank you for adding me to your playlist as well.
From the self-titled album Weird Al Yankovic, 1983's My Bologna.
And you can tell it's classic Weird Al, old Weird Al, because this is before they kind of simulated the exact sound of the track they were mimicking, you know? It was kind of their own, yeah, feel vibe to it.
Yeah, it was just him, Jim Bermuda Shorts.
Mm-hmm.
Hit a band. And this was like the Dr. Demento days. This is how Weird Al got his start. Yeah. Dr. Demento had a radio show. Syndicated radio show.
Right.
Weird Al would send his tapes in. Dr. Demento would play him on his show. And thus he gave us the world Weird Al.
Yeah, and soon became much, much, much more famous than the doctor himself.
And, I mean, this first... Now, he had songs out. I don't even think My Bologna was released before this album ever came out. A lot of... It's fun to watch the progression musically of Weird Al, too.
Yeah.
Where it is a lot of this, a lot of the burps, and a lot of food references.
Yeah, I used to have, it was called the Food Album. It was a whole album of just the songs about food.
Yeah.
That's all it was, yeah.
But on this one, you get, and I was just joking, we said we're going to play every one. We'll only play about half.
Yeah.
You had other classics like... So
I say this as a pretty hardcore Weird Al fan, but I'm fully aware that Weird Al is targeted to a lower level of nerddom.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's different. Like, it takes a certain person to like that. I'm one of those people, but I'm fully aware it takes a certain person to like that.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Weird Al is not for everyone. Though I will stand by what I said. He has had so much mainstream exposure.
And everyone knows,
Everybody, there's something Weird Al has done I think that everybody kind of likes.
We'll get to it in a bit, and I think his biggest song, we'll talk about it in a bit.
Because the fact that he continues to find an audience, this was, you know, this was 83. Weird Al's been doing the parody thing, I know, since the late 70s.
It's also crazy, so
going on 40 years.
As old as he is, he's staying relevant, like, his into the new music.
Yeah.
I guess he kind of has to, but yeah.
Yeah, like Portugal, the man.
Yeah, the man?
Let's see, and also this song is on this one.
Another truckload's coming in. Hey, Lucy, I'm home.
Oh, Ricky, you're so fine, you're so fine, you blow my mind. Hey, Ricky! Hey, Ricky!
I remember he shaved his mustache for this video.
Oh, yeah! Lucy. Yeah.
Because he's Ricky Ricardo.
Yeah.
Oh, Ricky, you're so fine.
And here's the thing about Weird Al, too. You think he, like, goes away.
Yeah, every time.
And then, you know,
it's always his comeback album.
Oh, he's back. Well, this was like Weird Al Yankovic was in 1983.
Mm-hmm.
And 1984 was in 3D that probably had his biggest hit up to this point.
Yeah.
Which was his parody of Michael Jackson's Beat It.
That's kind of when they started the whole, like, that's almost the actual Beat It soundtrack.
Yeah.
Like the background to it. You won't get no to
He had the same choreographer.
Yeah.
For the video, he used the same choreographer as Michael Jackson. A lot of food.
Yeah, oh yeah.
This one also had this song.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna bump it up just a little.
Eggs down the drain. But he's no bum. He works down the street. He bought the neighborhood deli.
It takes a long time to get to the chorus.
Now he's chopping up meat. Come inside, maybe you'll hear him say, try or the Kaiser, they're on special tonight. If you want, you can have an appetizer.
In 3D would also mark what would become a staple on Weird Al albums.
Yep.
And that is the polka medley. And these even change over time, the way they sound.
They do, yeah.
They tell us that we lost our tails, evolving up from little snails. I say it's all just wind and sails. Are we not men? We are Devo. Are we not men, Devo?
It's good to have
that. I love you.
And I got a DeVita on the accordion.
Wow.
Hey Joe, where you going with that gun in your hand? Hey Joe, where you going with that gun in your hand?
So many.
Gonna shoot my old lady. Tired of messing around with another man.
I mean, Jimi Hendrix polka. What else do you want?
I know. And then 1985, he would release Dare to Be Stupid, which was probably his biggest non-parody song at the time.
Yeah.
Also featured on the soundtrack of Transformers.
And Earth Station 1 podcast.
And Earth Station 1 podcast. Welcome to the Earth Station 1 podcast.
Yeah. It had to be scary for him. It had to be scary. Like three, four albums in, like, okay, we're doing originals here. We're doing like a big one.
Well, he had originals on the other, but they never, they never, you know.
Yeah.
But this one found an audience. He also did a cover of this.
Oh, yeah.
George of the Jungle theme.
George.
Or was
George
this used
of
in?
The jungle, strong as he can be.
I mean, it's a straight up cover. It's not a parody, really.
George of the Jungle lives a life that's free.
Oh, this is the life. You love This Is the Life. It's on the soundtrack song you love so much.
Yeah. This was from Johnny Dangerously.
Yeah, yeah. This is the big soundtrack album for him.
This might be my favorite Weird Al album.
Really?
No, it's not.
I'll tell you mine when we get there. I know it already. You know yours?
Yeah, I know mine.
Okay. I'm curious if we have this. Nah, I don't think we have the same one.
Maybe.
I don't know.
I eat filet mignon 7 times a day. My bathtub's filled with Perrier.
This is a great video, too.
What
cool, yeah.
can I say? This is a life.
All the Mr. Mom clips.
Yeah.
When I'm in the mood, I hire somebody to chew my...
Of course, this one. The first Star Wars. This was his first Star Wars parody, right?
Yeah.
Met him in a swamp down in Dagobah, where it bubbles all the time like a giant carbonated soda.
And what year is this?
This is 85.
Wow.
Others on this include like a surgeon.
Oh yeah, big video.
I want a new duck.
I had that single record of like a surgeon.
Man, this I love this song too. You know this?
To go just because it reminds me of you.
That's right.
See, you ain't gonna see me crying.
He's always like that doo-wop sound too.
Yeah.
I'm glad on Bad Hair Day, there's one since you've been gone. It's kind of
I was gonna play that one.
A little more acapella,
which is one of my favorites.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah.
Spend eternity.
Eating
shards of broken glass. Then spend one more minute with you.
He has a very dark take on relationships. Yeah. All his relationship stuff are so dark. Okay, of course, in the medley.
Yep.
What's love got to do with it? Who needs a heart when a heart can't be broken? M-E-T-H-O-D-O-F-L-O-V-E. It's the method of modern love. Owner of a lonely heart. Owner of a lonely heart. Much better than the owner of a broken heart. Owner of a lonely heart.
I don't remember this one. I'm trying to figure out what all is in this.
Yeah, I can't remember this one.
Okay, then we go to 1986's Polka Party.
Ooh.
Is the name of this album.
Not too familiar with this one, honestly.
But it has this one.
Hurts me to walk anywhere. Went to see my physician, Dr. Jones. He took my trousers off.
Living with a hernia. Okay. And my favorite Christmas song is on this one.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It's Christmas at Ground Zero. There's music in the air. The sleigh bells are ringing and the carolers are singing while the air raid sirens blare. It's Christmas at Ground Zero.
Robert Palmer parody.
Yeah. Is this on the Polka album?
Huh?
This is a polka? Wow.
This is polka party.
Oh, okay. Wow.
This is on your food one, isn't it?
That one is, yeah.
Because it's about addicted to potatoes. Yep. Addicted to spuds.
I can't deny they've got a peel. Whoa, you like them whether they're plain or they're stuffed. Oh, yeah.
Oh, is this... I'm going to guess. I think... I know this, but I didn't listen to this one. This is a parody of Who's Johnny from the Short Circuit soundtrack.
Really?
Yes.
Wow, I don't remember this at all. Remember that. Yes. This was 30 years ago. It's crazy to me.
I know. And here's a sample of this.
You could have a Big Dipper.
All right. And then he'd take a couple of years off.
Yeah.
Weird Al goes away. And then returns in 1988 with a... title called Even Worse, which was a play on Michael Jackson's Bad.
Right.
He's dressed like Michael Jackson on the cover.
Some of my favorite videos, by the way, this era here. I love the Fat video so much. So much.
Your butt is white.
The makeup
is mine is too. But watch yourself good. Or I'll sit on you. Oh. Your butt is wide. Well, mine is too. Just watch your mouth, or I'll sit on you. The word is out. Better treat me right, 'cause I'm the king of cellulite. Ham on, ham on, ham on whole wheat. All right. My zippers bust, my buckles break. Too much man
so good.
For you to take. The pavement cracks when I fall down.
Ding dong, man, I've ding dong.
You ain't fat. You ain't nothing. You ain't nothing.
And I never see my toes. When I'm going to the movies, I take up seven rows because I'm fat, fat, I'm fat. Come on. Really, really fat.
I think I'm a clone now. I'm guessing this is Tiffany's. I think I'm alone
right
now.
Yeah.
Born in a science lab late one night without a mother or a father, just a test tube and a womb with a
I think I'm a clone now.
Is there no polka on this one?
Is there not? Maybe turn in the accordion. Maybe not.
My lasagna might maybe spaghetti.
On the food album.
Good old days. I don't know this one. A Weird Al song. I don't know. Twister. It's a...
Yeah!
Huh. Yeah, it's trying to be a Beastie Boys. Yeah, yeah. Totally.
See, he does that.
Yeah.
He'll take like a style of song.
Yeah.
Which, my favorite is a Bob Dylan.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Good video, too.
Stuck in a Closet with Vanna White.
Was it something I ate or something wrong with my brain?
Okay, so that's 88. And then in 89, we get UHF. Which is the soundtrack to the movie UHF.
Great movie, by the way. Holds up, right?
It's so much fun. With such classics as Attack of the Radioactive Hamsters from Planet Near Mars. And this was a pretty big radio hit, I remember, at the time.
Oh, yeah. It's actually Martin Offa in that, right? Didn't he actually play in that?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Listen to my story. A little story about a man named Jed. A little something that poor mountaineer. They say he barely kept his family.
And another one of my favorite Weird Al originals. Because I think the true genius of Weird Al may be in his originals.
You think so?
Well, the title track to UHF.
Couch potato and you.
Which, in 2018, even the concept of UHF is totally lost.
Speaking of people who didn't know who Martin Shore was, think they would know what UHF means?
Yeah, exactly. I'll try that.
Yeah.
Do you know what UHF means? No. Okay.
Ooh.
The video to this is great, too.
Yeah, yeah.
The Billy Idol references, and George Michael, and Prince. The spatula
special
city.
Liquidation sale.
Yeah.
All nine spatulas get the 10th one for just one penny.
It's one of my first Instagram posts, which is like Spatula City. Christmas
presents. And this was a concept polka. It's called the Hot Rocks Polka. Uh-huh. It's all Rolling Stone songs.
You can't always get what you want. You can't always get what you want. You can't always get what you want. But if you try sometimes, you might find you what you need.
Oh, we gotta start getting through these. All right, in 92, he takes a couple of years off again.
Yeah.
And then in 92, he comes back with another. This was one of those where like, oh, Weird Al is back. Mm-hmm. And it was because of his parody of Nirvana's Smell Like Teen Spirit. It smells like Nirvana. This is a parody of You Kids on the Block.
Food album.
Oh, 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 the white stuff. Oh, oh, oh.
Rico Suave.
Yeah. Food album.
Taco. Grande.
And it's always fun to see where you are, what era you're in by the polka.
Right, yeah.
This is Rock the Cradle of Love. Sounds just like Rock the Cradle of Love.
Hey! Rock the Cradle of Love. In the morning, you can do me. In the night, you can do me when you wanna do me. You're the lady who is in light. And tonight, take my hand.
Up to Never Never Land.
Okay. That's Off the Deep End. That was 1992. Mm-hmm.
Classic Nevermind cover parody, by the way.
Yes. 1993, he would release Alapalooza.
Mm-hmm.
And it would contain...
This one doesn't stand out so much to me for some reason.
Yeah. Well, Jurassic Park, it's a takeoff of MacArthur's Park. The Bedrock Anthem is the Chili Peppers.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Because this is a weird time musically.
Yeah.
The Weird Al album is kind of weird.
Right. We've said it many times, but his backup band needs a lot of recognition as well.
Yeah, they're great.
Yeah, they're fantastic.
When I say genius, I'm not being facetious.
Yeah.
Or this one.
You can clear the room by playing Debbie Boone, or crank your Apple records until dawn. Oh, I could even hear Slim Whitman or Zamfir. Don't mind a Yoko Ono marathon. Or play some Tiffany.
Some Aerosmith.
Oh, yeah.
Living in the Fridge.
See, when I think I'm not familiar with the album, I totally am.
Yeah. And this polka was one song. It wasn't a medley. It was just Bohemian Rhapsody. And then in 1996, he would release, which I am going to call possibly my favorite Weird Al
album. That is my favorite. It's the one. That's the tag from the front.
Yep. A Bad Hair Day, of course.
Like I knew this album from start to finish. Yeah. I played all the way through. No skips.
As I walk through the valley where I harvest my grain, I take a look at my wife and realize she's very plain.
It's tough to hear Gangsta's Paradise. That's tough for me to sing and not sing this now.
I know.
I get them mixed up.
At 4:30 in the morning, I'm milking cows.
Jeff Florence Henderson in the video. It's the Michelle Pfeiffer character.
The guy who's seen the cord just sweating.
Yeah.
Even Ezekiel thinks that my mind is gone.
It's 96.
Yeah.
It's over 20 years ago.
Yeah.
Got a Bible in my hand.
TLC parody.
Yeah.
Waterfalls. Each time he
makes a collect. I never called it phony calls. Did you ever call it that?
No.
It's kind of a stretch.
That's true. It should be prank calls.
Yeah.
He's calling strangers up at 3 in the morning. Gives them pizza pie delivery.
You said you wanted Since You've Been Gone played on this episode.
Yeah.
There it is.
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
This is three of my favorite. This is why it's my favorite Weird Al. Three of the originals on this are three of my favorite originals.
Yeah, they're good.
This is my all-time favorite.
Really?
This is my all-time favorite original Weird Al
really?
Song.
Really?
Yeah.
That is a really good one, though.
I was driving on the freeway in the fast lane with a rabid wolverine in my underwear when suddenly I got...
Just try to picture everything that's happening. For the next, like, 30 seconds.
The chorus is great.
Yeah,
it's smart.
Yeah, it's very smart.
Right up and cupped his hands across my eyes. I guess they said Uncle Frank or Cousin Louie. Is it Bob or Joe or Walter? Could it be Bill or Jim or Ed or Bernie or Steve? I probably would have kept on guessing, but about that time we crashed into the truck. And as I'm laying bleeding there on the asphalt, finally I recognize the face of my Hibachi dealer who takes on prosthetic lips and tells me everything you know is wrong. Black is white, up is down, and short is long. And everything you thought was just so important doesn't matter. Everything you know is
when he
wrong.
Died, I mean, part
everything you know doesn't matter. Nasty paper. He tells me that they've got a dress code. Well, he lets me into heaven anyway, but I get the room next to the noisy ice machine for all eternity. And every day he runs by screaming.
Every day St. Peter runs by screaming.
Then this one.
Yeah.
Since you've been gone, since you went, I feel like I've been chewing on tin foil. Since you've been gone, it's like I got a great big blender and turned it on. You know I've been in a buttload of pain since you've been gone.
Well, since you've been gone, since you've been gone,
I couldn't feel any worse if you dropped a two-ton bowling ball on my toes.
Since you've been gone,
it couldn't hurt anymore if you shot.
I remember playing this song for my grandma. She's like, what? She never got it.
Since you've been gone,
since you've been gone,
it feels like I'm getting tetanus shots every day.
Shots every day.
Since you've been gone,
since you've been gone,
it's like I got an ice cream headache that
won't go away.
Ever since the day you left me, I've been so miserable, my dear. I feel
almost as bad as I did
when you were still here.
Well, the workshop is gone now.
So good too, man.
Excited to bomb it. Everywhere you'll find pieces of Cupid and Comet. And he tied up his hell.
Yeah, so that's Bad Hair Day from 96. Oh, yeah. The best Weird Al.
I think so too. Like overall. I said, start to finish, I can do that one all day.
Then in 99.
For me, this is one of the weaker ones, not going to lie.
Yeah.
This one I was aware of it and I was excited for the release and I'm like, meh.
Yeah, there's a couple on here that we'll play, but you have to recognize The Saga Begins.
You're right, yeah.
It's his parody of American Pie. Story goes.
Perfect timing for episode one, you know?
Yeah. He released this right before episode one, wrote it without seeing the movie. Based on spoilers he read online.
Really?
A long, long
That's funny.
Time ago, in a galaxy far away.
1999 online. Just text message boards.
Yeah. AOL.
Yeah.
And I left his home and kissed his mommy goodbye, saying soon I'm going to be a Jedi. Soon I'm
This also contained
this is a story by
the Weird Al Show theme.
Yeah. Sanitation workers really didn't approve, so he packed up his accordion and had to move to a city in Ohio where he lived in a tree, and he worked in a nasal decongestion factory, and he played on the company.
Of course, this one.
Varen Solfundira Blinza. Yeah.
How you doing, Bernie?
Have you seen the clip of Macho Man Randy Savage on the Weird Al Show? Like giving the elbow to the hamster?
No.
It's fantastic. Say a pretty
fly for a rabbi. Oh, this is one of my all-time favorites, too, though.
It's all about the paintings, baby. Yeah.
That's what his... in 2000, he had a tour, came to Nashville, and that's what the tour is called.
All about the paintings tour?
Yeah.
Remember, Drew Carey was in the video.
Really?
Yeah.
It's all about the paintings, baby.
And this was, like, high... Like, this was probably the most expensive Weird Al video ever. There were backup dancers and everything.
What you wanna do? Wanna be hackers, code crackers, slackers, wasting time with all the chat room yackers. 9 to 5, chilling at Hewlett Packard, working at a desk with a dumb little placard. Yeah, paying the bills with my math programming skills, defragging my hard drive for thrills.
And this is one of my favorite polkas too. And then 2003, again, Weird Al goes away for 3 years.
Hiatus.
And he comes back with Poodle Hat. Now, not a lot was released on this because story goes, this was supposed to be the big song. Eminem approved him doing the song because he always asked for permission before doing the parodies.
Except for Coolio, but whatever.
That's true. Eminem approved it, after it came out, refused to allow it to be released as a single.
Really? Weird.
This was supposed to be the breakout song, but it wasn't released as a single.
If you had,
that's different. There's like
one
different
shot
allowances for that.
Yeah.
To sit on your lazy
Well, I mean, they could have, but he didn't.
Watch all the TV, whoever.
They told me, but I'm still tuning every show.
Especially in 2003, you don't want Eminem mad at you.
Yeah.
True.
The Travel Channel, Discovery, and Lifetime. Lose your mind watching TV. They told me.
And there's not really a lot. I mean, there's this one, which is kind of funny.
I was kissing her so tenderly, but woe is me, who would have guessed her family crest? I suddenly spy tattooed on her thigh.
I feel running scissors and Poodle Hat. Those are
the two weaker ones.
Tell me, how was I supposed to know we were both related. Believe me, if I knew she was my cousin, we never would have dated. What to do now? Should I go ahead and propose and get hitched and have kids with 11 toes and move to Alabama where the kind of thing is tolerated? No, 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 no.
And Bob, which yeah. you have to... just have to study this song.
I'm an Amrigo.
The video's fantastic.
Yeah, what is that called when the word is the same forward as backwards?
Malindrome? Am I making that up?
Palindrome.
Palindrome?
Palindrome. Yeah, palindrome? These are all palindromes. Yeah.
Too hot to hoot. No lemons, no melon. Too bad I hit a brute. Lisa Bonet ain't no
bad. Again, done like a Bob Dylan song. That's why it's called Bob. And Bob's a palindrome.
I can't think of a more brilliant song he's done than that.
I know.
You see the video and the mind is blown. Like,
baby, do my yam.
That's funny. I mean, it makes sense totally. Like, the lyrics don't make sense like a Bob Dylan does, but yet it's making sense because it is that theme to it with the proper...
Satan sees Natasha.
With the proper syllables and heart. It's just weird. It's very smart.
Yeah.
No X in Nixon. Oh, Stone be not so. Oh, Geronimo. No minor ego. Naomi, I moan. A Toyota. A dog, a panic. In a pagoda.
That's so great.
It is, yeah.
And then probably in 2006, like Weird Al
came back
burst back on the scene by doing a parody of Chameleonaires. Rotten Dirty, called White Nerdy.
Fantastic. This made me love them again.
Yeah, this is one of my favorite Weird Al albums, too.
They see me mowing my front lawn. I know they're all thinking I'm so white and nerdy. Think I'm just too white and nerdy. Think I'm just too white and nerdy.
Love the MySpace
nerdy.
Reference in this.
Yeah. Nerdy. Look at me, I'm white and nerdy. I want to roll with the gangsters. So far, they all think I'm too white and nerdy. Think I'm just too white and nerdy. Think I'm just too white and nerdy. I'm just too white and nerdy. Really, really white and nerdy.
First in my class, they're at MIT. Got skills, I'm a champion of D&D. MC Escher, that's my favorite MC.
Oh, and then the Green Day parody. Canadian Idiot. And this is one of my favorite polkas, too.
Yeah.
Take me out, I say, you don't show. Don't move, time is slow. Take me out. Beverly Hills, that's where I wanna be.
Oh, banjo there.
Give me living in Beverly Hills, Beverly Hills, rolling like a celebrity. Give me living in Beverly Hills. And birds go flying at the speed of sound to show you how it all began. Birds came flying from the underground. And we'll all float on okay. And we'll all float on alright already.
Alright. Then he did take a break. Because that was in 2006. He didn't release.
Almost like a 10-year break, right?
Yeah, until 2011. Apocalypse. Seven, okay. And it all started with this one. Which is another one of my favorite originals. A song about match game staple.
I don't think I know this one.
Charles Nelson Reilly.
Oh, wow.
Charles Nelson Reilly.
But it sounded like
White Stripes.
You'd never disrespect. He stood 8 foot tall, wore glasses, and he had a third nipple on the back of his neck. He ate his own weight in coal and excreted diamonds every day. He could throw you down a flight of stairs, but you still would love him anyway. Yeah, you know you'd love him anyway.
When he decides he's going to do a song in the style of someone, it sounds just like a song I would do.
Charles Nelson Reilly won the Tour de France with 2 flat tires and a missing chain. He trained a rattlesnake to do his laundry. I'm telling you, the man was insane. He could rip out your beating heart and show it to you right before you died. Every day he'd make a host a match game, give him a piggy
piggyback ride. Yeah, a 2-hour piggyback ride. Giddy up, Gene.
All right, wow. Lady Gaga.
Doesn't mean right. I'm crazy. I perform this way. Perform this way. To my little monster's pain.
Molly.
So I get my handcuffs, my cyanide pills, my classified dossier. Tapping the phones like, yeah. Shredding the files like, yeah. And then my rhymes.
And one of my, again, another favorite Pokemon.
Can't read mine, no he can't read a my poker face. She's got the love nobody. Can't read mine, no he can't. I know just what you are. You say I'm crazy, I've got your crazy. You're nothing but a womanizer. You spin my head right round when you break your heart. I'm only gonna break your heart. I'm only gonna break your heart. Sunlight, tick tock on the clock, but the polka don't stop.
No!
Yodel only, yodel only.
Polka face, polka face.
It's the first time he'd done that with the polka, where he started with the and ended with the same song.
Oh, wow, yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
This next one is easily my second favorite, though.
Yeah, 2014's Mandatory Fun. This is the one, like, this was like the number one album in the country for
really?
A week, right?
Really? Yeah, I know it was big. I mean, even on YouTube and stuff, it was a big deal.
Wow, where do we start with this one? There's lots of good ones on
this
one.
Yeah, they're really good.
We'll start with this one.
Yeah.
It might seem crazy wearing stripes of pride. I Instagram every meal I've had. All my used liquor bottles are on display. We can go to see a show, but I'll make you pay. Because I'm techie. With my belt, with suspenders and sandals, with my socks.
Or this
I
one.
I never seem to finish all my food.
That's so good. This and Word Crime's my favorite.
I always get a doggy bag.
Word Crime's is one of those smart ones, too.
Yeah.
So I just keep what's
yeah, you have to understand.
Yeah.
Like, how to write.
Proper grammar.
Proper
yeah.
grammar, yeah.
Save it for later. But then I deal with fungal rot, bacterial formation, microbes, enzymes, mold, and oxidation. I don't care. I got a secret trick up my sleeve. I never bother with baggies, glass jars, Tupperware containers, plastic cling wrap, really a no-brainer. I just like to keep all my flavors sealed and tight with aluminum foil. Always psychotronic scanning, don't mind that. I'm protected cause I made this hat from aluminum foil.
I wonder if he has like a committee he runs these by. You know, every single song he hears is a parody in his head.
Yeah.
He has some yes men around him, or does he have people that are like, no, that's no good?
I think he has the no, that's no good.
I think so.
Because he rarely misses with the parody.
The definitions of nouns and prepositions. Literacy is your mission. And that's why I think it's a good time to learn some grammar. Now did I stammer? Work on that grammar. You should know it. It's less or it's fewer. Like people who were never raised in a sewer. I hate these word crimes. Like I could care less. That means you do care. At least a little. Be a moron. Hey, you better slow down and use the right pronoun. Show the world you're no clown. Say you got an IT.
The good thing is this could be used like a classroom.
Yeah, this could really be.
As a possessive. It's a contraction. What's a contraction?
Well, it's the shortening of a word or group of words.
Okay, now here's some notes. Syntax, you're always mangling. No X in espresso. Your participle's dangling. But I don't want your drama. If you really want.
I'll get listen to the whole thing.
Oh, yeah.
And then there's this one.
with my bag of tricks.
Bag of tricks.
Where you going? Your disposal is rusted.
Rusted.
My problem making you disgusted.
Yuck.
When your front window is busted. Just one name that's always trusted.
I'm so handy. You already know.
And again, a fantastic polka.
Yeah.
These are a lot more melodic than the early ones.
We jumped, never asking why. We kissed, I fell under your spell. A love no one could deny. Don't you ever say, I just walked away. I will always want you. I can't live a life running for my life. I will always want you.
Another catch-up.
You better dance. Let's make a night. You won't need to get lucky. We're up all night to get lucky. We're up all night to get lucky. Up all night to get lucky. Yes, we're up.
Man, I should have brought in a former lover of Weird Al for this episode of the show. We could have done that.
Who?
We, you know, down the street here.
There's a former lover of Weird Al down the street?
Remember the story of he came to her doorstep and knocked on the front door and...
No.
Oh, I'll tell you later.
What?
I told you before. You forgot? Yeah. You'll hear the story. You'll be like, oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I remember that.
Yeah.
So now that's all the Weird Al albums.
Yeah.
This year he did release this, which I think this is probably from a forthcoming album.
Probably so.
How does a bastard orphan son of a whore and a Scotsman dropped in the
that's
middle
great.
Of a forgotten spot?
The Hamilton polka.
Grow up to be a hero and a scholar. The $10 founding father without a father got a lot farther by working a lot harder, by being a lot smarter, by being a self-starter. By 14, they placed him in charge of the trading charter. Alexander Hamilton. My name is Alexander Hamilton.
The soundtrack is amazing, though.
Yeah,
it's good.
I haven't done, but just you wait, just you wait. Wait for it, wait for it, wait for it. I am the one thing.
So, if we were playing that hits the Spotify, top five right now,
oh, wow.
White and Nerdy, uh-huh. The Hamilton Polka, Amish Paradise, Word Crimes. Word Crimes is number four.
Nice, okay.
Feel It Still.
And some
feel
of those have,
It Still.
Some of those have millions of downloads. It's good.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah. I mean, Amish Paradise has 11 million.
Huh.
White and Nerdy has 12. Party in the CIA. That is way more popular
that's
than
weird.
I thought it
yeah,
would be.
I didn't know that.
Foil. The Captain Underpants theme, which we didn't.
Oh, wow. The old stuff isn't so loved, is it?
Not really.
Some Eat It, some Fat. I never heard of the song before.
So yeah, that is kind of the complete works of Weird Al.
For the most part, yeah. The highlights, at least.
Yeah.
Yeah,
the almost complete works.
Yeah, yeah. Have you ever seen him live?
I've seen Weird Al live 3 times.
Really?
Yeah.
I always wanted to. Is it great?
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's just as good as you think it would be.
Damn.
The last time my wife and I went to see him at the Ryman is where we saw him, and it was probably the Alpocalypse tour.
Mm-hmm.
So he had, and I don't think he released this online, but they did animated videos for a lot of the songs on that. And so that's what you would watch during the costume changes.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But he did the polka. Now, that's what I call polka.
Uh-huh.
He did that live.
Really?
Yeah.
That's cool.
That's crazy to do a polka medley like that live.
Yeah. I hear his costume changes are pretty awesome, too.
They are. Yeah. Like, he brought the fat suit. He had the fat suit.
Really?
Yeah, he did fat. A lot of costume changes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So does his band sound as good live as they do? It sounds like the actual song when they're playing it live, huh?
And they look their age. I don't think Weird Al really looks his age.
No,
I mean, he looks older, obviously, yeah. than, you know, when you look at this picture from 83 or whatever.
Yeah.
But yeah, his band, Jim Bermuda Shorts.
Yeah.
Yeah, he looks like an old man playing the drums.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, but apparently Weird Al lives a clean life.
Yeah.
Clean food, clean living.
Right.
So I guess it works.
Yeah.
I guess you stay looking young-ish forever.
I'll try it next time.
Yeah. Next go around.
Yeah.
Because everything you know is wrong.
That's true. I was down.
So we started by playing the Portugal, The Man remix.
The Man?
Yeah. Well, there's one more. They actually commissioned two remixes.
Oh, really?
My
I like this song better.
Yeah. Make sure you check us out online.
Oh, sorry. I'm in the zone here.
AdamandJP.com.
AdamandJP.com. Facebook.com/AdamandJP. Check out Patreon.com/podcastroll. I'm in the Weird Al zone here. I'm sorry.
I know. It's okay. It's understandable.
Of course, on Twitter, @AdamandJP as well. Check it out.
If you would like us to do a complete works of your favorite artist, let us know.
Or like a 5-star review on iTunes. We'll talk about you all day.
That's true. Like Foxglove Farms.
Don't forget it.
I'm Jay Patrick. That's Adam.
Eat your podcast roll.
This has been a production of the Adam and JP family of on-demand talk radio.
AdamandJP.com.
Right now.